Sit back and get comfortable. Guess I'll tell you what, if that didn't get your blood going, we give up and we'll just all go on home right now. Thank you. She's 16 years old, by the way. Junior is our high school teacher. We're real proud of her. Well, Carol and I are real happy to be here with you, and I don't think we can possibly live up to what John Beck has been telling you all. Because I've heard several people come up and say, boy, John Beck's just talking. I say, well, I hope you didn't believe everything you heard, because we can't possibly be as good as he said. But we're going to do our very best. We're real, real happy to be here. The Reynolds are friends of ours, and we're just real happy to be at the church. In fact, Christy Reynolds is Lisa's best friend, so we've really been looking forward to being here tonight. We'd like to get started. I can find what we're going to get started with. This is sort of our motto. We, you know, Carol and I are both originally from Texas, and we've always talked about Southern hospitality. We've always known, you know, that you're supposed to be very hospitable, very friendly, and all. Those of you that are all Texas natives know that. And so this is our motto. There's always an extra potato.
You can take to remove that pleasant ache. You're not sick, you're just in love.
It just reminds you that when everything goes wrong, there's there's always hope, and you just have to have faith in God. And it talks about the people in the Bible and how they deal with disaster, and just keeping your faith in God in prayer.
Unfortunately, John Beck saw it. And so he said, be sure to do that. You know, whenever I was in school, I taught school for a little while. I taught 3 years spread out over 13. You know, I'm one of those real steady teachers. It took me a long time to teach a year. It took 7 years. Sort of like the way I went through school. I took 4 years for my master's and 5 years for my master's. My parents thought I was never going to get out of school. But you know the reason it took so long to get out of school? Is that we spent half of the year reviewing what we learned last year. I know some of you are teachers. Don't you ever get tired of teaching the first grade, the first half of the year in the second grade? And every year as it goes, you know, if we could just teach stuff once, the kids wouldn't forget it over the summer vacation, things would be better. Well, so I really think that all the kids learn, they learn the very first year in school, and we just review it for the next 15 years. Show you what I mean.
This is how a kid learns in junior high, standing in as a kindergarten kid.
Thank you.
course, you had to hear when I was in high school. Somebody can't remember that far back. Little boy, bring your coat, blow your horn. The sheep's in the meadow, the cows in the corn. But where's the little boy who looks after the sheep? He's under the haystack, fast asleep.
Higher learning.
They learn not to do it anymore.
the musical comedy, The Fantastics. Two songs, right? Carol and I will do one, and then Lisa will do one for you.
I've liked
Sweetheart Bank would be complete without this next song. I used to be a real estate, I've done almost everything in the world. Just ask me if you want to know about something. But one of the things I did was I was a real estate broker in Colorado, and this was a song that I used to tell my clients. Let me call you, sweetheart.
Cuckoo. Do. Addie.
Oh.
Do and dee. My body lies over the ocean.
My body lies over the sea.
My body lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my body to me.
He plays in the air with the greatest of ease, then tearing up that on the ground track.
She'll be